Joining us on the show today is Rawlson King. He's a lead researcher at Biometrics Research Group, which is a news and market research outlet for a wide range of businesses, from Fortune 500 companies to everything as startups. Rawlson, the first question I want to ask you is, do you think that biometrics are eventually going to replace the dreaded password that we all use, and we probably have 20 different passwords? Are we moving to a place where we're no longer going to be using passwords?
Absolutely. I think that's the goal right now of biometrics, is to replace the approach towards authentication that we take now towards, you know, websites, towards our computers, towards different consumer devices like smartphones. So the idea is to phase out the password, because the password, as we know, has a lot of flaws to it. Often people forget their passwords. Often they use really silly passwords like 1234 or password itself. And so, you know, it's very hard, therefore, to ensure the safety of data if we use passwords, since it's such an insecure method of authentication. And biometrics is obviously much more secure, because it is utilizing, you know, identifiable components of ourselves to allow access to sensitive data and information. So we will definitely see an increase in the use of biometrics versus passwords. In fact, major corporations like Microsoft, in terms of their operating system, are seeking ways actively to phase out the password. So I could say probably within 5 to 10 years, we can expect the death of a password on the web, expect the death of a password with operating systems, and definitely expect the death of the password or the passcode on smartphones.
So in 5 to 10 years, no more passwords. And you noted Microsoft, and I know Google as well is working on this technology. You know, it's interesting because you said how a lot of people will still use 1234 or password, a lot of these very common, easily hackable, not safe passwords at all. If you're a person that is trying to steal information, whether or not that's bank account information or engage in identity fraud, you know, it's pretty easy to do. You could just simply have a botnet that controls a series, large series of computers, and just blast out tons of these very common passwords, 1234 password. And then just by the law of statistics, you know that someone out there is going to get hit, and you might end up, you know, if you send out a billion different spam messages, or if you hack a billion different computers, you're going to come back with a number of hits. And that's what we see today, is you see just identity theft being rampant on the web. And there's a huge cost to both businesses and consumers today. Tell us a little bit about some of the numbers and the figures that you discuss in your recent research report in terms of how much people are paying for this.
Hi, everybody. John Loeffler here. You know, you've just been listening to a free preview of the Financial Sense Insider Premium Edition. Do you need help making sense of the market? I mean, you've heard the old adage, it's a jungle out there. Well, you know, you can join our premium weekday service, and you'll gain access to leading experts, analysts, and market technicians on what's driving the markets, the economy, and your future. You can get all of that by subscribing today at financialsense.com. That's Financial Sense, S-E-N-S-E, like you're trying to make sense of something, .com. And click subscribe to join our premium weekday service. You won't regret it.